everyone. Sorry for the mess up. It's my fault. I was late. I'm surprised that there's not an additional screen, so now I just have to turn it on a little bit. Oh, it's there. Oh, sorry. Yes. That's perfect. Yes. So, I'm going to talk primarily about publishing games. First of all, a little bit about myself. So these are my contact details if you guys want to reach out later on. I've been working within the games industry for a little bit over 10 years, primarily on the business, sales, partnership side, AMA head of Raw Fury. Now at Raw Fury, I overview mostly like the revenue side, making sure there's money coming to the company selling games, different kinds of partnerships, with different platforms for publishing, new regions, licensing, all kinds of things. Many people are asking us what kind of games we publish at Raw Fury. And that is a very tough question. What I would ask back would be like, how do you feel today? Because then I can tell you which games we do. Because we don't define our games based on genre, it's more based on emotions, and we publish a spectrum of emotions. Why I say this, you know, like games, I feel like games, same with books and music, you know, they are about the emotion you have when you listen or you read to them, and I think games should be the same. We have all of us, we have moments when we go home and we just feel depressed or sad, and you know, maybe we just want to cry it out, or you know, just cuddle on the couch and have something, or drink one, or one drink, or a glass of wine, and then you just look, it's like, yeah, I want to watch a movie that will just help me cry. And I think with the games, it's the same. You play a lot of games based on what you feel. So we have games that you can enjoy when you are sad. We have games that you can enjoy when you feel the need of some self-confidence, some empowerment. We have games that are showing that it's okay to be anxious. We have games that are showing that being different is okay. That being a kick-ass heroine is okay as well. And my favorite is we have games that bring people together. And why I'm saying this? Because one of the main challenges I have when talking about the games and when promoting them is like, chopping them or molding them in a pre-established template or genre in order to fit what the stores are asking for. And these are some screenshots of the genres for the main stores. As you may see, many of them are very similar. Funny coincidence, Google and IRS, they have exactly the same categories. I don't know who copied who, but I found that quite funny. But also, Steam, you know, just a few genres there, same with GOG, and I don't feel that actually represents what the games industry is nowadays and the creativity that is out there. I just think it limits so much the potential of your game. And also, it makes it so difficult for users to find the kind of games they really need at the right moment. I don't like the way they do it. Also, I'm not sure that the way Epic is doing it, where there's no category yet, you just scroll a lot and scroll and scroll in order to find games. I don't know if that is the right way to go either. But, I don't know, I just hope that at some point there are going to be some stores who have, instead of these old genres. They have, emotions, like, and, start focusing on the cover, start focusing on text and pre-established genres. Maybe say that, yes, today, do you feel sad? Maybe this is the game for you. Do you feel that you need some confidence? Maybe this is the game you should play as well. This talk was actually supposed to be more about post-mortem on our game of day, but I think it's one of the one game that challenges the most everything you know about traditional gaming and genres. But unfortunately, I cannot do the post-mortem because the game is being delayed, indie publishing. Never on time, so I cannot really do that. But I will try to do a summary of all the takeaways from all our games, and many of them. First of all, it's okay to be brave, and it's okay to be different, and especially now. You have the chance to do it for gaming. I know it's very difficult to sell your game when it's so different than what's out there. And it's so difficult to find a home for it in one of those stores. But I'd say don't give up, because the same way that we love games, there are also other people there that work in this industry, and they might resonate with your game. And or maybe there's going to be someone like a new platform coming up that is actually going to be a home for this game that doesn't fit anywhere else. And something I like a lot was about Apple Arcade, because this is what they're trying to do. Make this platform for games that are not traditional to-play games, but also they are so difficult to promote on the traditional premium PC stores. I hope they're saying they understand it, so I really hope that is going to be the case. From my point of view, going cross-platform is good, although it's very, very challenging when it comes to technical adaptation, porting, installations, everything. But it's less risky, because now the market is so fluctuant, changes so sudden, and it's so difficult to predict which platform is going to do better for your game. And here I have an example comparison between the our game, one of our games called Andara, then at launch. So that is in the first graph there, is the distribution among the six platforms that we released the game, Steam launch again. And then, as a comparison, is our revenue distribution sent on the same stores on a month when we have a sales campaign, and then on a regular month when there's nothing happening. And you can see, it's so different in all the three of them. And I can tell you, when we released Andara, I read my forecast and I was like, totally different in terms of what would be the main platform. And I was like so surprised it was not at all what we were expecting. And then so happy that we pushed ourselves and we still launched. And we didn't leave any money on the table. Look outside the gaming industry. And when I say this, I refer to influencers. Stop looking and trying to reach out all these expensive influencers in the games industry. It's so difficult to get them to play your game, to promote your game. But maybe there are other influencers there that might connect with your game, especially if it's a game that has a inspiration from the real world, lifestyle inspiration. So, in this picture here, the ladies that cosplay Dandara, they are just like lifestyle influencers. And I think it made a higher impact than we were only getting. Yeah, any other gaming influencers we try to work with. This talk about your market online. Don't try to compete with what the big companies are doing. You're not going to win, and you don't have the budget that they have. So stop trying to do the same things that they are doing, and stop trying to acquire the same users. You're just wasting your money. But you can be creative, and you can do other things, and try to convert people who maybe don't identify themselves as gamers. So instead of maybe doing one of those very expensive trainers, you can just go to a farm if you have a game with animals, and you can, you know, record it yourself. You can think about the fact that people who love farming, they might be single. Set up an app for them so that they can connect in the game, but also outside the game. Something else that we've done for Mosaic, instead of, you know, spending our money on these ads, nothing against ads, but just that it doesn't work for us as much, we've done a clicker. So when the mobile came, a clicker, but we put it there for free, and we got so many users starting the game. So at the end of the day, the user acquisition cost was much lower than if you just tried to acquire the game through other traditional acquisition methods. And because Mosaic, it's about, you know, salary math simulator and about corporate world and corporation and just being a number in a big company. What we've done, we created this website that actually makes fun about all this corporate world. And we even have a section there like apply for jobs. But if you read more in depth, you'll see just like subscribe to our newsletters. But it's incredible how many users actually subscribe to it. So, like, it's way more than for any other game campaign we have done so far. So, you know, just think outside the box and do other things. That is going to help quite a lot. Stop defining your audience just like some numbers there, like male between 18 and, 35, located in this geographical area. I think your users are more than that, and they should be more than that. So, why not define them like close to casual farmers? I listed so far some of my takeaways, but I have way more. So, planning is key. I know it is very difficult to plan a piece of art, you know, like it's ready only when the artist really feels it's ready. But if you're also trying to make money out of it, and if you want other partners, platforms there to help you out, you need to try to plan a little bit and stick to a release date. Because then you're going to become maybe the preferred partner of those platforms, because most of us, we don't stick to the release date, and they get very frustrated with us, so maybe you're going to be one of those who are not going to get that negative reactions from them. A discount for at least 4 months of extra development, especially if you go Steam cross-platform. You know, going a little bit releasing on consoles, both into consoles, submission certification takes 3 months at least. Take advantage of platform marketing activities. Many of us don't take the time to do that. But actually, if you try to connect with them and listen, you'll see like there are so many things they can do for you. And I know it takes a lot of time. It takes a lot of time to to keep in mind when Nintendo might review build for their GDC show, right? And then having a build for that just in case they might choose you. It takes time to write a blog for them. It takes time to submit your pitch for Nintendo Direct or the PlayStation Live show and all these events. But yeah, it's worth it. New markets, it might surprise you that your game that you thought might work very well in US actually might have high interest in China or Japan or some other places. So it's possible, try to be aware of those new markets. More channels, more visibility. It's difficult to handle and release your game on several stores, but think it like this, like your game is going to be listed on more internet pages, so more impressions, more eyes on it. And at the same time, now, since it's very difficult to get visibility on Steam or on the big stores, maybe there is a smaller store that has better audience for your type of game and might support you quite a bit. So, for example, if you have narrative-driven games and Steam, you cannot get attention there. Maybe you can consider a store like Atomic, who have a very good narrative audience. Quality is key, that's the method of the platform. Pricing. Very, very challenging to come up with a price for your game. We have a lot of debates in the company around this topic. We look a lot at the competition, but I feel like we are the ones who know best how much it costs them to make a game, what's in there, and how much the game should be valued. So I don't like when I get a lot of questions like, oh, you should put this price because all the other games are the same. I feel like if we cannot convey why our game is worth that price, then it's a problem with messaging around it. Just trust your gut. Do not discount too early your game. Do not put it on high discounts. But it's better to have like smaller discounts more often. Do not pitch your game as something that is not. Users are going to find out, and they're just going to regret it after that. So we don't have time any longer, but I'm just going to bring all the other takeaways here. And if you guys want to take a picture, you can ask me later more about it. My favorite one, and I think many of us, we made that mistake. When we use consoles, we don't look at the key art from distance, so far away. Make sure you do that.